First of all, thank you, Mark, for creating this amazing Discover program and hosting it here in Hamburg in one of the most beautiful cities in the world. I think that's really very special. And I already see it, how it's growing. And this is like a seed. We plant a seed. And we will see how it grows, because there's a season for everything, and we are in the Four Seasons Hotel. So, and this is the time to plant the seed, and it will grow, and we will see how it will expand. I already see that. And Discover, I think it's a great name. Discover something new, something more. And you talked about it, how it impacted your life. And so I'm really excited to discover something new, something more. Are you all excited to discover something more? Yes. So, something more about chiropractic, something more about life, love, joy, passion, excitement. I think that's what it's all about. And if I look around here and see this diverse group of people coming from different journeys, coming from different backgrounds, and what brings us all together? And here we can see it. Yes, Discover, it's the power of chiropractic.
And you've got to give me a chance. I need... Dr. Roesener is full of life and energy, but I first wanted to introduce you.
Okay.
Because
sorry.
I said how I met Dr. Roesener. This
true,
is maybe one of the smartest human beings I've ever met in my life, and she was traditionally trained as a cardiothoracic surgeon, and she didn't go and get a doctor of chiropractic degree, that she originally came from medicine. But Dr. Roesener is a CEO of Epienergetics, which was formerly Donnie Epstein's company, Wise World Seminars, that is basically network spinal analysis that's teaching the world this amazing technique. Those of you that don't know about it, when we put the video out, we'll put links so people can have a look if they want to see.
Now network spinal.
Network spinal.
Network spinal, that's the next evolution.
Okay, but it is Epienergetics now.
Yes.
So I just wanted to introduce you so people understood who you were and what you're doing. Carin and I have been working together for years and years. We worked together here in Hamburg in the same practice for many, many years. So, but also, we also do things on the side that are hobby. My hobby is working on German doctors, and her hobby is trying to get the chiropractic community pushing NSA, well, just NS? No,
now it's NSA.
I'm sorry, it's been NSA for 20 years for me, but
well,
Carin is rebranding the whole thing.
Actually, it's more about epigenetic. It's more global, because it's really not only network spinal analysis. It's not about the technique. It's really, we all share a common objective. And the common objective is really serving people, uplifting people, and I believe this is really the message, what brought us all together. And it's the excitement about the philosophy of our founder, of D-Day Palmer, who actually said, unite man, the physical, and unite man, the spiritual, and that the universal intelligence can express itself collectively, individually, in the best manner possible. And that's really what is in the center. And that's also what epigenetics is about. It's about the conscious and ecological use of energy and information, being part of that universal intelligence. And that is really guiding us. And may I continue?
I just want to introduce you, Carin.
Because that's really, when you asked me, tell your story, because I was looking, what is this story? My whole life is a story.
Yeah.
And I realized, actually, life is guiding us. Life is guiding us to a certain point, to the point here, to make chiropractic, or I would even say that message, a center of our life, a center of our being with everything. And then we realize, oh, sometimes we get off track. So, and these are the stories we talk about. And Discover, well, what does Discover really mean? It means, hey, we need to have a look. We need to look what's really going on. And then we realize, shit, I got off track. And when we discover that, that's a magical moment that's shifting our life in an instant. And I believe we all can share so many magical stories we experience with our patients, practice members, every single day, and we all have our own stories. And I have to say, well, many times I was pretty much off track, and I realized it. Well, it took me a while to finally wake up, because if we don't listen to our calling, it's getting louder. And so that's really the magic of a story, and our whole life is a story, and it's guided by that universal intelligence. And I could talk about specific stories, the story how we met in Hanover when I just had a car accident, how I met Susie, how I met John Paul, how I met Corinna, how I met several of you here, and it's not an accident. We were guided to that. And also for me, and I believe many of us, we all had a vision. And I believe we have a common vision. And the common vision is really, we want to help people. We want to serve people. And not only people, we want to serve humanity. And that's really what brings us together, no matter what is our background. And that's actually the center of our story. We are of purpose. Hey, we realize something is off. And I could also talk about my healing stories, or I would say even many healing stories, because it took a while until I realized. So a personal healing story, one of them was I probably had more than 100 surgeries. That's a time when you stop counting. I have been resuscitated 120, 150 times. Unfortunately, I was not listening to the calling, and we all know it. We don't listen and keep on doing the same thing over and over. What is the outcome? The same. And finally, I realized, oh my God, there's more. I have to live my purpose. I have to fulfill my purpose. I literally was on the other side when I realized that's not it. There's more. And I discovered it. That it was a huge, it was a magic discover moment. And when you realize, oh my God, there's more. You are part of that universal force, that universal intelligence that is guiding you. All of a sudden, the power is on, and everything is possible. And you have infinite possibilities. And, well, and then you realize sometimes you get off track again. And when you are in it, quite often you say, why me? Why now? But that's actually the whole purpose. We need an interruption in our life to stop exactly what we are doing to do something different. It's bringing us back on track. And I remember even an interview with Nelson Mandela when he became president of South Africa. He was interviewed and they asked him, wow, it's great that you are the first black president of South Africa. How was it for you? It must have been a horrible time when you were in prison. How was it? Share that experience. And he said, it was one of the most wonderful times, and it was a time I needed. It was a glorious time because it was preparation. And he said, I needed that preparation time. So, and we all, we get shaped like a tree, like the wind is shaping a tree. We get prepared for what we really have to bring into the world and what is our legacy. And I believe that's really why we are here, to discover what is it really about. And I would say, yes, it's chiropractic, and it's even more. Didi Palmer, he didn't create chiropractic. He was the founder of chiropractic because it's a universal principle. And like Newton, he didn't create gravity. He discovered it. It's a universal law. And if people are saying, oh, chiropractic is dying, maybe it's dead. Yes, if we look at the system, and if we look at all the system, if you look at the medical system, and many of you here made the same experience I made. Yes, we have been idealistic. Doesn't matter whether it's medicine, chiropractic. You want to serve people. And then you realize, oh, there's that system. The system conditions you or wants to condition you in a certain way. And that's opposite to the original vision you had many times. And especially if you look at medicine, what's going on in medicine? It's not about people anymore. It's not about serving a person. That was maybe 100 years ago when you had the good old GP, the good old house arts. He knew the person. He was taking care of the person. Mm-hmm. Not only the person, the whole family. He was aware of the entire environment, what was going on in the field, that universal intelligence, what's guiding really everything. Then it became more specialized on different organs. So we had the cardiologists, we had the nephrologists, the urologists, and we know we are more than just a bunch of organs. And now we even don't look at organs anymore. Now it becomes metrics. We look at numbers, and we all know we are more than just a bunch of numbers. There's so much more. And that's really the message we have to bring back into the world and to discover. And I believe humanity, the people out there, they want to discover. They have a different option. And as I said, chiropractic might be dead. Might be dead or is dying. Let me rephrase it. Yes, the system chiropractic might. The original message can't even die. It's impossible because it's a universal law. That is the real power. And we all share this message and this common objective. And it's not about fighting about any technique or whatever. That's a strategy. And the universal law can never die, no matter what the system is. And I believe that's something we need to discover and share it with the world. And hopefully, we have next time here 500 or 1,000 people and bring this message to the people who all need that, who want that, who are really not satisfied with the system and who are looking for that message. And the system, the current system in most of the countries in the world is not delivering that need, what people really want to have.
Well, we're going to deliver this message over YouTube so we can reach all of the 8 million doctors in the world. But I want to discover one thing about you, Dr. Roesener. I want to take you back because I, like most people, I like people's stories. I want to know, originally, when you were young, why did you want to become a doctor?
Well, my first desire was actually, I wanted to fly to the moon. I wanted to fly in the universe and the galaxy. What I do
well,
to some extent.
Well, you want to be an
astronaut. So, yeah. Well,
okay.
It's like, so I wanted to be free. I wanted to fly. That's why I want to stand up. So, and well, but traveling the universe, that's a whole different story. And then I wanted to be with people. I always wanted to serve people and help people and support people. And that was my ideal. That was my original motivation.
And you had a 1.0, so you're like, I'm going to get the MD.
So it was like, okay, well, actually, first I wanted to go to dental school. And my father said, no, that's a small part of the entire system. You want to learn the entire body and not only about the teeth. And well, if you still want to do it, you can do it later. So I did it both at the same time, and I started doing that. I was not allowed to take the exam, but I wanted to serve people.
But you started, was it before or during medical school? You went to Hungary.
Yeah, that's where I started. Yeah.
Dr. Roesener didn't just go to Hungary to learn anatomy. She first had to learn Hungarian.
No, actually, it was taught in German. It was taught in German.
But you learned Hungarian.
I also learned Hungarian. Yeah, I had to learn it. Yeah.
Just a small little thing. Which is really impressive to an American. We're not really language people.
In order to go to the school, you actually had to take care of people. So there was a requirement at least 6 months. So
was
you had to work in a hospital.
Was that in the middle of when you were in medical school?
No, it was the beginning. I started there.
Okay.
I started there.
But that's great. Yeah, you started with anatomy.
Oh, yeah, and that was the reason why I went to Hungary, because my father said, well, he was not happy with the German system, because in Germany, most of the times, you have just one semester of anatomy. And we had the whole 2 years, and we were small groups of 20 people. And we had to be there, and, well, we had our own bodies, and how it all goes.
Yeah,
so
but look,
learning the body and dissecting the nervous system.
But to me, that's a fascinating part of your story. And then when you were doing, in Texas, you were doing a residency?
Yeah, that was at the Texas Heart Institute. I started with an internship. I went 3 months there.
And so, to prove what a small world it is, years later.
There he is.
I meet another friend of mine, and I know him for about a year and a half, and we're out to dinner one night and realized that you two, back in the early 90s, had been together in Texas.
That's true.
Talk about a small world.
That's true. And But I find that all fascinating. Well, you know, life is guiding us.
Yeah, yeah. No, I believe in all that. I'm just saying, the part of your story, this is all part fascinating of where life took you. Then you went to Yale.
Well, that was a time later. So actually, at that time, I wanted to become an orthopedic surgeon, and I had already done a chirotherapy seminar in Kiel, at the university in Kiel, and I didn't like it at all. And actually, when we were in Texas, it was at one of the parties, I met a chiropractor. I said, oh, chiropractic, I don't like that at all. So, and he, and he was a Palmer graduate. And they said, oh, what is it what you don't like? I said, oh, cracking these bones.
You gotta be careful, we got some old Palmer guys in here.
Yeah. And he actually, he told me the philosophy, what it's about. I said, oh my God, that is the total different what I learned here with chirotherapy. So, and I actually got excited. So I got back and I did at the Texas Chiropractic College a hospital rotational program, so in chiropractic. And I got supported at that time. And you know it, the name Denton Cooley opens every door, so everybody bows, so you get in, and he actually supported it. And I went to Yale later because, well, life was shaping me again. I had a breakdown, and I had an osteomyelitis. They did not know whether it was contagious, and that was a time in Germany when there were some scandals. They said, no, you can't practice on people.
So but I still heard that you graduated top of your class.
So, and then I went to Yale and became a health economist. So if I can't work with people, I said, okay, I need to change the system. And I was doing consulting for insurance companies, for hospital and the pharmaceutical industry. So I said, okay, that's a different way. Until we met and finally...
That's when I met you in Dr. Pianta's office.
Yes, exactly.
It's amazing how life unfolds.
And finally, okay, and that was the story. I was never contagious. And it's time to go back into practice. So, and I think we started working in 2006.
That's amazing, yeah. Isn't it, how life unfolds?
And that was also part of the shaping when I met you in Hanover. I was just hit by it was a car accident. I was hit by
a
cobblestone.
Something, it came through the window of the car.
Yeah, it was a cobblestone. Yeah, I was on the highway. And the truck, it was a stone between the tires, was accelerated through the window, hit me right here, and yeah.
Okay,
I had some challenges.
Last question, and it's from you, from sitting and talking the other day on me, what good questions to ask. What is your vision of the future?
My vision of the future is really share our message to the people. Because to humanity. Let's not be only our professionals here. Let's bring in the people who need the care, who are craving the care. Bring in thousands, millions of people. I want to create a movement. We want to serve people. We need to have all these people here. People need to know. They need to hear about it. And especially in Germany, if you talk chiropractic, people have no idea what it is.
That's why we have you here.
So, and the real message, we need to bring it out.